Things that we'd like to do, we don't keep refugees for recycling.
So we're not really talking about people who are actually rejected, but there are people in Canada right now who can't access Canada, and we're cutting them off. So in the interim, I think you're giving the message that all you're targeting is people that have been rejected and are supposed to be leaving, but there's a lot of people.
The people accepted to Canada.
The government is just
individuals accepted to Canada from the same healthcare as all Canadians.
But that's not really what it says in the document. So a
lot of Canadians. I would check.
And the point is, and you said it right about the indigenous communities, that people deserve a different approach. So refugees are not the same as poor people in Canada. So some of the poor people in Canada, we set up these safety nets, and we treat those people that nobody's without their diabetic medication or cancer. But if you're telling the refugee population that you're not paying for those, in essence, you're saying
what
you're
we're
not
saying,
getting
yeah, what we're saying, no let me explain again. What we're saying here is that if you come into Canada and you're going to get the same care as all Canadians, Canada.
That's what we're saying.
I would ask you please do your research further, because that's what we're saying. And people that are rejected to Canada will no longer be covered by our healthcare system.
That's
rejected.
That's a bit of a red herring, because we're not talking about it. But what do we do with those people anyway? We're not going to, if somebody floats up on the shore with a broken leg, we're going to help them.
I thank you for your feedback, and I would ask you to do your research.
Okay. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.